guys. It's Ben. Going to give my review on the Sydney FC game from Western United yesterday. So it's a little bit different because I didn't get, obviously I wasn't in Melbourne, down in Geelong at the game. But I went to my local pub, went up to Ingerdane Tavern and watched it with one of my mates. As I said, it's going to be different. I've written down a few points of what I thought was good, what I thought was bad. Me and my mate were talking about it yesterday at the pub, and we both sort of agree on what I've got written down and all that. But let me know what you think of this video in the comments below. Obviously, I was going to do something like this last week for the game against Perth, but my priority last week was to get the video out that I did, which was my 30 days of no social media in October. As I said in that, it's probably the greatest thing I did. If you want to go check it out, go head over and watch it after this video. But let's get stuck into it. Playing Western United down in Geelong, it's more of the unknown sort of factor of never having played them before, being their first season. But just watching the game like that, we had a really good first half. We seem to do what we've been doing the last couple of weeks, what we did in the second half against Victory, what we did most of the game against Perth. We looked solid going forward. We looked like we were creating plenty of opportunities. I think that all stemmed from how solid we were through the mids. I think so far this year, Bratton is playing a completely different game. I was saying to my mate yesterday and one of the other guys that I saw show up, it seems to me that he's come out of Melbourne City where he seemed to have to be the linchpin, getting everything going, and now he can just play and be himself. He doesn't have to be that integral member, just has to do his job, get into that dogged fight for the ball, and that's when he's at his most dangerous, that's when he's killing it the most. But he seems to be doing that all right, and I think he's been a really good pickup for us so far. Same with Bomjahan. I know there's some people that don't like him, but I rate him so high. I'm so happy we've got him. His work rate down the wing, especially yesterday, with the way he took the run setting up Alfie's second goal. Beautiful stuff. And on Alfie, like him and Costa just seem to be working really well together. And one thing I've noticed is their work rate off the ball, getting into space, opening up those solid passing lanes. It's making it so much easier for us to look for that forward pass first before we look back, which you look at Sydney for the last couple of years, that's been our bread and butter. We always go forward before we go. We always go forward. We try not to go back. So that's where I think our strengths are. But like another point that I think from the game yesterday is watching it was the ref seemed to have very little control. Like, don't get me wrong, I love those tough games, those hard challenges going in all the time, but it was getting to the point yesterday where luckily no one did get injured, but it was getting to that point where he'd lost control to the point players could get injured. We don't want that in the game. You want the best players out there, but if there's games like that where the referee loses control and challenges going in because they're harder and harder because they're not getting booked, you're going to risk putting great players out. But at the end of the day, luckily there were no injuries. We came out of the game pretty unscathed, but then onto the second half, wasn't the best. Wasn't the best second half. I'd say average. We seem to just sit back to defend the lead. But it's wish we wouldn't do that. It's like we put unwanted pressure on ourselves, unneeded pressure. And that, like, admittedly, in that last 10 to 15 minutes, we did show, the whole team showed what Bratton was, with that dogfight, getting the ball, just sticking strong. But I wish it didn't come to that. We had our foot on the throat. We should have just not let it off. Like, we should have kept going hard. But at the end of the day, it's, we created chances in the second half, but we just seemed to be of that mindset of let's defend the lead. Like I said at halftime, 2-0, I was talking to my mate and I was like, 2-0, I hate having a 2-0 lead at halftime is the worst, because it's that era of the game where, that area of the game where if they get the first goal, their game's back on. But if we, you know what I mean? It's, so I didn't like that, but again, we showed that they would find us 10 to 15. And like at the end of the day, it was, for that second, looking at it now, played a proper professional game in that second half. And for the majority of the game, we just did what we had to do, got in, got the 3 points, got out. But I think in games like that, we do also need to make a statement. Like, don't get me wrong, Western United's defence was good. They had a good defensive structure, something that Mark Rudin had pretty good at Wellington Phoenix last year. But it's when we're creating those opportunities and getting down the wings, we need to try and be more ruthless in those sort of games. But yeah, overall, it was a super professional game. Got the 3 points. That's good. That was it. But I hate, but now I like to bring up what I've heard after the game from people that were there. I'm disgusted by it. The way that the fans were treated by security. As I said, I wasn't there. I've seen the reports from people that were there at the game. Like, I hate that I have to talk about this, but it happens. And it's ridiculous to the point that the police had to step in and tell the security guards to leave the fans alone. Like, it kills me inside whenever I hear about this. And it's like the way that us as football fans are treated in this country is ridiculous. We wouldn't be treated the same way if we were at a rugby league game, if we were at an Australian rules game, or if we were at the cricket, would not be treated this way. I wish I knew the solution. Like, I know with Sydney, I've seen it at away games and at the home games, they have the supporter marshals. I'm pretty sure a lot of the other clubs are doing it as well. It's similar what they do the same thing throughout Europe. It's disheartening that every so often we talk about it. Just, I hope we don't get to where we were a couple of years ago with the walkouts and the boycotts of the games. And I just hate the fact that no matter what, no matter how, what good we do in this country for the game, as fans, as supporters, that this small minority of people are doing what they can to kill the game, to get rid of the game. And in my opinion, I think it's because they know that it is the world game. The games they play, like, the closest you got is probably cricket. And like you saw it the other way, yes, Sydney and the Sydney Kings in the basketball have sort of like papered over the cracks, but like that report from the so-called journalist, like you don't see like football journalists bad-mouthing other codes. And the only time you do is when it's in retaliation to our game being bastardized in the press. It makes me sick when I hear about this and hear all the slander on our game. But unfortunately, it's the country we live in. Like, many few friends have even said, we're born on the wrong continent. It's with the way that we're treated for this game. It's the way the game's perceived in the public viewing. I've spoken to friends that don't even watch the game, and all they go off is what's said in the press, which is a joke. And then I've also got friends that have never watched the game. I've taken them to games with me, and they're hooked. They love it. And now at least they've seen the side that what the media portrays is a joke. But I'll stop talking about that there. This is the end of the video. If you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button. As I said at the start, let me know in the comments down below. If you watched the game, what did you think? If you're at the game, what did you think? And as much as we don't want to talk about it, if you're at the game, let me know in the comments below how bad it was with the security. But yeah, so end of the day, enjoy yourselves, have a good time, but most importantly, keep living a great life. Peace.